But up next, ladies and gentlemen, the Intercontinental Championship matchup. It's Owen Hart in a title defense against Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Me and Owen were going to have a hell of a match. And we had this plan where he'd end up hitting me with a tombstone piledriver. And I said, you go down to your knees, right? Because I'm looking for clearance. He goes, no, I go to my ass. I said, but it seemed like you got to go down to your knees. He goes, no. And when Owen said, this is how I do it, I trusted him because he's Owen Hart. And so anyway, we get out there and things go like they did. And man, he goes to his ass and my head is sticking out about 6 inches below his ass. And boy, I got spiked on the mat and it was not good.
Let's see what Austin can do with Eamon. No.
Yeah, it was gnarly. You could tell immediately that Steve was, you know, that he was injured.
I'm afraid Austin was hurt.
It sounded like someone hit a big gong, and that was my skull, you know, striking that damn ring dead center in the middle. And then I didn't feel anything because I'm laying there and I'm paralyzed, and I was like, man, on one hand, I could have freaked out and got scared, but instead, I remained calm. I was like, don't touch me, I can't move. And so he starts buying time, because I think I'm never going to move again.
As soon as he got injured, I called his wife up. I said, hey, did he really get hurt? Or was this a show? He said, no, he really got hurt. It was 1997 to this day. I cry about it every time I hear about it.
I'm thinking, I got to get out of this match. I got to get out of this match so we can go back. And Earl Hebner's a referee in that match. And I told Earl, I said, tell him roll up for the win. I thought I could start moving my arms and legs. And when I tried to, if you go back and watch that, it's like my knees are creaking to get in a crawl position. And I can't crawl like this because my hands don't work. So I had to crawl using my forearms. And I give him the initial thing, and he goes with me, and he doesn't try to fight it. It's the worst roll-up in the history of the business.
Driving, knocking out!
And man, I am gone. I've been, you know, a quadriplegic for 60 seconds, and my world has been turned upside down. The referees come to the ring, and three of them help me up. I got my arms around their shoulders, and I pull them off because I want to get up, and I want to address that crowd and hold up that belt. And the only reason I held up that belt was to signal the crowd that, hey, man, I'm cool. And man, when you look at that, my eyes are open, but I'm worlds away. The referees help me to the back, and as I'm walking, this leg is dragging behind me quite a bit because of my nerve damage.
I watched Steve stand up on legs that he couldn't feel. I don't know how in the hell still that he was able to get up. That's a will that supersedes what the body can do.
Everybody thought I broke my neck. I didn't break my neck. I bruised my spinal cord. I'm a pretty tough guy. On that night, I was 1% tough and 99% lucky. You know, and that's why I get a little bit emotional about it, because if anything would have went any differently, I'd have been in a wheelchair. I wouldn't be sitting here talking to you. Nothing that ever happened after that would have happened. Everything was on the line.
Get the ambulance people. Where are the ambulance people?
Get the ambulance.
You want to just call 911 or what?
Get the medics.
No, they're over
the. And I'd put a pair of shorts on, and I was sitting up there against the wall, and I was like, well, I was shaking. I kind of started crying a little bit because it scared me so bad.
I think an injury of that magnitude makes us question our own mortality, and that's not something we're often faced with.